I feel everyone has a calling, something they're passionate about. It is important to follow your dreams, because if you let someone put you down, you'll miss out. You could miss out on something big you could never get back.
I see myself in 10 years in a hospital being a doctor for children.
I see myself become a professional architect who designs buildings.
Well, I really see myself as a speech therapist.
In 10 years, I see myself as the Taekwondo Olympics champion. I really want to become champion. I want to be well known.
I see myself as an athletic trainer.
I'm going to be a cop.
I want to be a lawyer, because I like to help other people and save them, especially for the innocent. And I'll like nothing more just to know that I saved someone. I actually see myself as a teacher.
I'm a famous singer.
I see myself being very successful. Hopefully I can be a gymnast for the Olympics. Be better. Gabby Douglas or even me.
I see myself being a professional soccer player.
Touring with a band that I've created during college.
At the moment, I have a contract with a talent agency, and we're taking really small steps, but those small steps are the things that count.
I just recently got done with Junior Achievement, and I'm not gonna lie, it was a really great experience.
I'm not gonna think about the negative thoughts like, oh, it's like so many years to become a pediatrician.
To go to school, University of Austin, as a good law school in Texas.
I guess just do what I do now, you know. I draw a lot, I draw in my spare time. And I like to experiment with different styles and try to figure out different meanings of inspiration.
I've been doing this since I was 4. You have to stick to this daily. It's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Created my own amateur film production.
I'm working really hard, getting kind of sleep deprived, no real social life, but I'm just taking as many AP classes, dual credit courses.
Continuing studying biology and going to my 4-year college.
Oh, I wanted to be a movie star. Doesn't everyone? Right.
The very first time anybody ever asked me that question, I was in first grade, and my teacher, Mrs. Creekmore, asked what we wanted to be when we grew up, and my first thought was, I don't know. But then, by the end of the day, I had drawn a picture of a teacher standing in a classroom.
In about seventh grade, when I first heard Nirvana's Smells Like Teen Spirit, a friend had shown it to me, and I was already playing guitar at the time. When I heard that song, I wanted to be just like Kurt Cobain.
I always dream of just being an actress or just sing. But growing up, I discovered that that wasn't my talent really.
But when I went to high school, my dreams changed because I had a wonderful math teacher. I really loved math. I would skip my PE classes to solve math questions. I know that's not something that everyone should do, but that's what I did.
My childhood dream was actually becoming an engineer. And I was planning to study civil engineering when I go to college.
They should be given opportunities, and they should be able to experience different fields that they can pursue.
I think the biggest thing for kids trying to achieve their goals is to know that you have to work hard. Nobody's gonna just give you anything.
Do things that they like to do. When they will like go to work, they will be happy and excited on the way to work. When they will go to the bed, they will have a dream what will be next day.
I think above all else, no one can really understand what's in your mind but you. It's hard enough to explain what your dreams are to your best friend, much less to the public in general. So I think only you know how to follow your dreams.
Everyone has something they're made to achieve. How we get there is what's fun. Even though the journey is long and takes dedication, it all works out in the end. For me, I've always loved editing, directing, and anything film related. This film is just part of my journey.